is a gorgeous sunset over the west coast of Florida on a chilly evening here in Tampa. You're watching The American on ESPN. Welcome inside the Sun Dome, everybody, where the USF Bulls have established a dominant home court advantage. Hello, everybody. Ari Shanock along with my partner, Angel Gray. And Angel, USF as one of the most potent scorers in the nation.
In the nation, indeed. And right now, she's leading the American in scoring, as well as threes made and her free throw percentage. That means she is the most impressive shooter in this league. And what she does so well is just understanding, even though she came off of her freshman year being the freshman of the year in this league, she has gotten even better and has improved in many areas. And it's going to be a very interesting and very smooth game from her tonight.
And Tulsa, they rely on a pure playmaker at the point position.
Erica Wakefield has been the floor general for this team. Matilda Mossman had told me that she has grown this year, understanding what she needs to do as a leader. And right now she has 14 games with double-digit scoring, as well as two games already in a double-double. So she has improved drastically. We have a great game ahead of us, and I'm excited to watch both players go head-to-head.
USF Bulls, like we said, they've been dominant here at home. 11-game winning streak here at the Sun Dome, Angel.
And that's what they do. They're known to win, and they're coached very, very well. But more than anything, they want to win. They don't want to just be behind UConn. They want to be the number one team in this league.
And the Golden Hurricane, led by Matilda Mossman. She's plenty of experience and the keys for her Tulsa Golden Hurricane.
Well, we were speaking with her earlier, and she said we need to make sure that we get back in transition deep. They can shoot it from deep very early, as well as scoring in their offense. Right now, South Florida has great length, so they have to make sure that they can get around it. And for South Florida, balanced attack. Everybody on this floor can score in many different ways, and they can do it very quickly.
And they are under the guidance of Jose Fernandez in his 17th season, 297 victories for Jose. He has been outstanding. What a program he's built. 12 of the last 13 seasons he's brought them to the postseason. And it doesn't take long for Loxa to get on the scoreboard.
We were speaking with the SID for South Florida earlier, and she said, you know what, we have to make sure that our fans aren't standing too long, and Kidia make sure of that.
And Tulsa led by Wakefield with that starting lineup against a woman-to-woman defense. The jump shot is short. Battle for the rebound won by Henshaw. And she will win plenty of those rebounding battles. Three-pointer in transition. This is something that the Bulls will look to do quite often here tonight, is that transition three-point shot.
Well, the transition offense is about 25% of their offense, but what they are doing in that offense is scoring 50% of the time. Their efficiency is like no other.
Locks up. Terrific ball movement. Loxa leads the USF starters, but Pujol and Flores have been outstanding. Two to nothing Bulls. Tulsa will try to get into the lane and try to scramble this defense, but it's not easy to do.
It's not, especially with the length. They're going to have to make sure that they can penetrate as well as find the shooter, but passing around the perimeter is going to be tough.
And Wakefield with a wicked crossover puts the Golden Hurricane up on the scoreboard. She is averaging 14 a game.
Don't let the frame fool you. Her size may be a problem as far as South Florida, but she's definitely taking advantage of that and finding her first look for a nice pull-up.
And Pujol got poked in the eye as Golden was looking for the steal. Alexis Golden, the 5'8 freshman out of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Coach Mossman called her best perimeter defender. And can ill afford to have Alexis get in foul trouble.
But you like that she can stop early, but right now, if you're going to defend anybody, it's going to have to be Katia Loxa. She can definitely let it fly, and that's something that everyone in this country knows, so you can't lose her on that three-point line. Do everything that you can to bump her offline.
42% from three-point territory. The runner bank too strong from Wakefield, and physical play underneath sent to the floor. Well, as the Golden Hurricane, Kendrian Elliott, there's a 6'2 freshman out of Wichita. Here's the Gatorade Kansas Girls Player of the Year at Wichita South High School, leading her team to a 6A state championship. A good look at Coach Mossman. with a plethora of experience on the bench in her sixth season. 5-2 Bulls for the tie. That was a bit short from Spurl. And in transition, here comes Pujol.
It's going to have to be a little bit more movement on the offensive side for Tulsa if they want to come up with better looks at the basket.
Jesperson, another big weapon offensively for the Bulls. And good denial defense by Tulsa. They caused their first turnover.
Which is really good if you're looking at what just occurred as Spurl. Getting up, making sure you're making Loxa very uncomfortable, pushing her outside that three-point line and making her make a decision under pressure.
Golden, beautiful feed underneath and scoring. Left of the rim is Elliott, the powerful freshman.
Perfect offense, nice roll to the basket, finished very well.
Jesperson, a little back door, that's denied, nearly stolen, but knocked out of bounds. Nicely done by Ashley Hughes, one of the senior leaders for Coach Mossman. Coach Mossman began her career, coaching career, at age 24 as the head coach of the Arkansas Razorbacks in the early 80s. Was 67-27 leading Arkansas. A terrific coaching matchup. Pujol lost her footing, and that will be a walk.
And that's everything that she was telling us that she wanted to do at the beginning of the game, just making sure that if they are running their offense, we're making them uncomfortable. We're going to throw different things at them, but the main thing is not to foul them. Great job on that defensive series.
And a good help defense by Elliott. Coach Mossman was very happy with the Golden Hurricanes perimeter defense and their victory over Memphis. Good skip pass for three, in and out. And almost nailed it was Hughes. On the run, Loxa, stripped and stolen. Terrific hands by Wakefield.
You got to credit right now South Florida getting back in transition D. That's what Tulsa wants to see, if they can come up with some extra opportunities in transition to score.
And unable to finish after the good move by Elliott. Here comes the pure point guard. She has been terrific as Flores, the senior out of Spain. She got poked in the eye. Three-pointer, Jesperson. Heel the rim. And a strong rebound. A couple of terrific freshmen in the American Conference battling right there. Angel.
With Tamara Henshaw right now, the week, the player of the week, the rookie of the week for them right now, and she is very physical. You can see now, right, you have to make sure you put a body on her, and that's something that they cannot continue to do in this game. Perez just missed out on the opportunity there.
Loxa jabbering at the official. She thought she was bodied. A little screen and roll pass deflected. Tulsa, very active hands. Straight on three. Couldn't knock it down. It was Flores. And here come the Golden Hurricane, trailing by one. There's the open three for the lead. Pujol in transition. This is where they are very dangerous. Loxa. Bam.
That's why they're dangerous, because they have weapons on all corners of this floor, and being able for Loxa to trail, communicate coming down in transition, that's perfect offense.
So Loxa, the 14th leading scorer in the nation, has a quick 7 points. Pujol for three. And weak side rebound. She is a terrific rebound at Henshaw. Averaging over 7 rebounds a game. Had a double-double versus Stetson.
If you've noticed already, the transition offense for South Florida, putting up those early threes, that is their transition. So, and then their offense. So making sure you know that for Tulsa, be ready for it. Be ready to rebound and contend.
Loxa, catch and shoot, quick trigger. She's got that very quick release, which makes her so difficult to guard, Angel. And you take a look at the pure shooter, the leading scorer in the American Conference, Katia Loxa, leading the way for the Bulls. Eight points for Loxa. As South Florida doubled up on Tulsa, 8-4 for Coach Jose Fernandez. As you look at the series history, 2-0 for the Bulls. And Coach Fernandez, the Miami native, he's guided this USF program to 7 20-plus victory seasons. He's been outstanding.
Both coaches are revered very well in this league, and you can tell just the respect that they have one another and just coming into the game understanding that it can go either way.
Open three for Tulsa. They need to have those. They've been very scrappy, making things difficult for the Bulls. They're outside shooting just 2 of 10 now under Coach Mossman, who also coached at Kansas State. It was 80-66 for the Wildcats from 84-89.
Right now for Tulsa, they are 0-for-4 from the three-point line. Now both teams are shooting well over 35%, a little bit over 35%. So right now, go with what's working. They only have 2 points in the paint. Make that 4. And that's 4 for Erica Wakefield in the paint. But making sure, if it's not broke, don't fix it.
Well, Wakefield, that's where she does her damage, Angel. She hasn't been that efficient from three-point territory this season, but averaging 13 a game, shooting 45% from field.
So it's really tough if you're a three-point shooting team as far as Tulsa coming into the game. It's not dropping for you early, but that's your game. How do you adjust? And at this point, it has to be making those shots in the paint.
And that's Jespersen with the offensive rebound, a 6-foot junior out of Denmark. Had a double-double in the victory over Tulane in their conference opener. Terrific, scrappy defense by the Golden Hurricane. And this is Nudge in the game. She causes a collision with Golden. Dorotia Nudge, the 6'2 freshman from Hungary. Highly recruited player, Angel. Listed as the number one recruit out of Europe by Blue Star Europe and Passion Hoops.
Over and over again, just meeting with Coach Fernandez, even in the summer, he was like, we have a player that you're going to love to see in her, and just making sure that those international players come in, are very smooth, learn quickly, and he has a good group with him right now. They are buying into the system. They know how to play well, and the one thing that he said to us earlier was, no one's coming here afraid of anybody because no one knows about the leagues that much. Now we have the internet where you can watch all teams, but they just want the opportunity to come over here and play.
Jespersen in the post, gets it back, puts it up, and it rolls in.
Another impressive player, Jespersen. Third straight double-double that she's coming into this game with, so she can definitely let it fly. 26 points and 15 rebounds versus Stetson.
So you're saying the foreign players on the Bulls are not intimidated by UConn and their 89 in a row, huh? Because that's who they play at Tuesday night.
Well, you definitely can't think about being intimidated going into the game because you've already lost. Yes, respect them, but one thing that Coach Fernandez has said over and over again is that we can compete with them or any other team with the best of the talent that we have, and I trust these girls. They're young right now. They had a great shot at them last year as well, but I don't think any of those players are intimidated at all.
This is the freshman Nudge. Jespersen has good range. Loxa being hounded by Hughes, puts up the three anyhow. Jespersen battling again. Coach Mossman asking for an over-the-top foul on the rebound, but it will be Tulsa possession. See Coach Matilda Mossman. She sends in the game Tatiana Perez, a 5'6 sophomore out of Cypress, Texas.
She was complaining about that over-the-back call, but with her size for this roster, going against an average of about 6'2 from South Florida, don't leave it to chance. Make sure you put a body on somebody and finish at the rim.
And with weak side help reaching, picking up the foul was Loxa. Kendrian Elliott is a presence in the post. Hey, look, they're coming over to double team, Angel.
And it was late, and that's one thing that they have to do. We already said earlier that the three-point shot isn't falling for them. So finding Elliott early is perfect. She is their best field goal shooter, so get her the ball. And she's one of the best rebounders as well. So just making sure you don't forget about your big players in the paint.
Elliott has been impressive, averaging 9 points a game. 49% from the field. Checking in for Tulsa is Henshaw. She returns. Also, Hughes will get a break after playing fantastic defense all over the court. So 1-2, and trailing by a field goal is the Golden Hurricane. Flores. Jespersen along the baseline. Another offensive rebound by Henshaw.
She has been on the board something heavy. And if you understand what she's coming in this game as, the rookie of the week for this league, put a body on her. She is known to be on the boards.
Screen and roll. Henshaw had it rejected. A clean block by Spurl. Lisa, the junior out of Tulsa, local product.
I like that look, making sure that if you do get to the basket, you're not going to get a clean look. Great clean block by Spurl.
And there's Loxa. She now has 9 points. They've been impressed with her versatility this year, Angel. Not just an outside shooter. She can hurt you in so many ways.
Well, last year she was known for the three-point shot, and this year now, speaking with everyone, she has a nice pull-up, can get all the way to the basket, and can create her own shot. You want to see that in a shooter, and she's just a sophomore. The wealth of knowledge that she's had from these coaches is unbelievable, and one thing that she said she is in this season, and it's prepared, and she's really anxious to show the rest of the world that.
Off the curl, Jespersen. Flores, possibly the best floor leader in the nation. She leads the country in assist to turnover ratio. Here's Loxa all the way to the hoop. No help defense. Tulsa was fortunate though. At the buzzer to end the first period. Tulsa hanging in there with USF. Jespersen has done some of the dirty work for Coach Fernandez. Jespersen has been active, and Loxa on fire for the Bulls. They lead it by 5. 11 wins in a row for USF here at the Sun Dome, and the crowd loves it under the all-time winningest basketball coach for South Florida. And what do you think of Coach Fernandez's troops with their keys to the game here?
Well, right now I said have a balanced offensive attack, and Kitty Aloxa has been that balance. She scored all but 2 of the points. The other 2 have come from Maria Jespersen, but also for Tulsa right now, efficient offense and transition defense. For their transition D, they have held South Florida to only 3 points, and that was Kitty coming down for the 3. But also to learn in offense that they have to be better. 0 for 4 from the 3, but they are starting to get the ball inside. Right now they're shooting 27% from the field. Make it better in the paint.
So Loxa, who has 10 points already, that is half of her average of 20, which leads the American Conference. 3-pointer, yes!
If she catches the ball, she's in range. And what I do like about her is that she gets her feet around so quickly. And even right now, her finger is taped. Her shooting finger is taped because it was broken in a game, but she finds a way to get a nice shot up.
Yeah, Tulsa struggling offensively. That's the lowest scoring output against USF in the first quarter this season. Jespersen for 3. You can't turn your back on this team.
What's even more interesting is that Kendrian Elliott turns to the bench and goes, I don't know what else to do. And at this point, they know that they are one of the best shooting teams, three-point shooting teams in this league.
And a big three-pointer by the freshman Golden. Tulsa did not score for the final. 3:57, and Loxa wide open in transition.
It's a three-point shooting contest, and I don't think that Tulsa wants to get into that with South Florida, but I do like to see right now that Tulsa is starting to hit some of those outside shots, so South Florida is going to have to guard them on the outside.
Golden works against Jespersen. Here's Wakefield. Looks for help and finds Richards, another freshman out of Bixby, Oklahoma. In the post, Elliott has been productive, takes it strong. Got her miss, but it did not hit rim, so shot clock violation. Turns it over to the Bulls.
Elliott is clearly upset about that attempt, and she's throwing it over the goal. I thought she had a great look at the basket, but then that's where it comes in for Tulsa, just that vocal leader. Who's going to step up and really understand? Who's going to let her know how much time is on the shot clock?
There's Flores, 14th in the nation in assists, 3.91 assists to turnover, leads the country. A rare turnover for the Bulls. Parker also into the game for Coach Mossman. And this is Shook Dixon. Spot on three, side of the rim. Jesperson handles another rebound. Here's Flores looking to attack. Jazz Bond into the game for Coach Fernandez. An impressive 6'4 freshman out of Murfreesboro, Tennessee. There she is.
6'4 freshman and doesn't like to be inside at all. Her small frame, they said, we're trying to do everything that we can to get some meat on her, but there's not much we can do. But I know one thing that's for sure is that Tulsa's going to have to find an answer for Kitty Aloxa.
Aloxa, beautiful pull-up floater. She now has 15 points. She scored 38 points last January on this date. They tried to answer with a three. January 7th, 2016, she had 38 points against SMU. That was the most ever by a freshman at USF, and that was the second highest in American Athletic Conference history.
Just up too much, and right now the officials for this year have said it and made it plain. You cannot put your forearm on a player or impede the process. You have to keep your hands off. No hot stove whatsoever. Straight up defense.
And Angel, you were talking about it in pregame, that was something that the European players had to get used to here in the NCAA.
And with the majority of this roster, if you're looking at South Florida, playing international, that's something that they did have to grow to. And we said before, even as Flores gets another and one, she has grown tremendously in this league. Last year, she wouldn't go all the way to the basket because she had Courtney Williams that was in front of her, or Springfield, going behind the back and finishing and one.
So pretty. Laya Flores, who has just 10 points a game. Coach Fernandez has been so proud of her improvement. And his team, the 22nd ranked Bulls, they lead it 25-10. You're watching The American on ESPN. It's been the Katia Loxa Show. 18 quick points, 7-12 in the field, 4-7 from beyond the arc. She is unbelievable.
I told her before the game that I wouldn't be like her when I grow up. If I had the shooting form that she did, I think I'd still be playing. But the ease, it comes with ease for her. And she was frustrated because the last couple games, she hasn't been hitting. She went 2-for-11 when they played Tulane. But she said, I want to be better. And just for her to say that and still average 20 points per game, you understand the pressure that she puts on herself to be the best.
And they are perfect 5-of-5 here in the second quarter. They're on an 8-to-nothing run, the Bulls are. They've extended the lead to 16. Tulsa has to take care of the ball, and another turnover. That is their fourth. On the attack, Loxa lobs just over the fingertips of Jesperson.
Just passing it a tad too late in transition. You want to get it up the floor as soon as you can.
There's Wakefield. Good ball movement here on the perimeter for Coach Mossman and the Hurricane. On the drive, the floater is in. A beautiful move by Addison Richards.
Great move by her, and very smart, by the way, just knowing that the defender is coming at you running. So a nice pump fake, got her up, and then avoided the foul. Great move.
Loxa, she doesn't need much room. Bam! That is her fifth tray here in the first half.
I've kind of run out of things to say about her, just as far as how quick she can get her feet around. At this point, I would switch on a lot of the screens and see if there's anything else that I could do for her running on the baseline.
Yeah, you've got to hedge quickly and get right in her chest. She gets that shot off so quickly, it's difficult. Beautiful take and score by Erica Wakefield.
Got to see more of that from Erica. She can do it every time if she wanted to. She's that crafty in the paint.
That's Pujol. Draws the blocking foul on the Golden Hurricane. That will go on Elliott. That is Elliott's second foul. They can ill afford to get their big freshman center in foul trouble.
And that's going to come with maturity and an understanding of experience as well. Defensively, getting your foot on the baseline and not allowing the person that you're guarding to come across your hip.
So Tyja Scales, 6'1 sophomore out of Houston, checks in. Offensive foul setting the screen as Pujol got tangled up with Wakefield.
In the right place at the right time. Very smart for Erica Wakefield to step up and take the three, sacrificing her body for the team in extra possession. But we're going to keep an eye out on her right now. She was grimacing coming up. I think she might have tweaked the ankle a little bit.
Yeah, Erica has 4 points, averaging 13 a game. Here's Scales, finds Wakefield. Wakefield likes to penetrate and facilitate. Here she goes. Cut off by Jespersen. Good help defense by the Bulls. But found herself wide open and nails the short J is Hughes.
I think she shocked even herself, but great awareness for her to pump fake, look around. The best option came down to her.
And a rare turnover committed by Flores, who I mentioned a couple times, worth mentioning again, leads the nation in assist to turnover ratio.
Coach talked about her growth and how impressive she has been in the offseason playing with the international team and being able to gain some confidence in that and in her being a point guard as well, knowing that she didn't get a lot of the opportunities last year with the two point guards they had last year on the roster, two being very impressive. Courtney Williams, who is now in the WNBA, playing for the Connecticut Sun. So this has been her year. Really honed in what's best for her.
So a walk is whistled against Scales. Flores has played on the Spanish national team since the age of 12. Could you imagine? I mean, that's experience. By the time she's, about 21 now?
It's a nice resume.
It sure is. On the curl, Pujol, her teammate from Spain. Jespersen, short corner, Jay is in.
And had too much time. She was able to come down with the ball, line it up, get her elbow tucked, and knock it down. And there has to be a communication on the defensive end for Tulsa.
Tulsa a little bit demoralized. They're so aggressive and intense defensively. Started out so well on the defensive end, but now they've had some breakdowns, Angel. And they trail it by 15 here in the second quarter. Richards. Pull up 16-footer contested, and bearing it is Ebony Parker, the junior from Houston.
The transfer from Blinn College also. We were talking with her earlier about how she's been able to come in immediately impacting this team and her maturity, as well as being able to take the big shots.
And she can shoot it, Parker. Keep an eye on her. She holds the NJCAA Division I record from Blinn with 144 three-pointers. Here she is. Here's Golden, actually. Golden to the rim, hooks it up. Battle for the rebound. Great effort there by Scales.
And that is a great effort for Scales, understanding that she is the only one in the paint at this point, and she has to go with reckless abandon to try and get the ball off the glass because there are four players for Tulsa moving back to prevent the transition offense for South Florida.
Tatiana Perez, an offensive foul, setting a screen on the inbounds pass. This will be on Richards. Addison, one of the talented freshmen, very young team for the Golden Hurricane. One of the reasons that 7 of their 10 losses have been by single digits. They've also lost 3 games after leading by double digits.
They want that to be better, and that comes with maturity, as Coach said before, but being able to step up and not make excuses and just knock down shots.
Perez in the corner. There's Golden. She's going to be a good one. Step back three. Difficult shot, and the rebound to Lotsa. Pujol, beautiful feed across the lane, and the easy deuce, and one for Henshaw.
I think at that point, Tulsa just got caught watching the ball. And when Parker took that outside shot, it's usually going to be a long rebound, and South Florida did a great job. Kitty Alaksa pushing the ball up the floor, no bounce, making sure you can get it to your freshman of the week. And she was able to definitely convert in that situation, and Tamara Henshaw has proven herself to be very physical in the paint and reliable. One word that Coach said about her was consistent.
Yeah, Coach Fernandez very impressed with the freshman, her composure out there for a young player. The lead is 15. Golden, shot by Pujol. Tough floater at the lane. Heel of the rim and the rebound to Loxa. Here comes Katia, surveying. Terrific ball movement. Pujol, great crossover. Jesperson from 15. Well executed, though. This wouldn't fall.
Tatiana Perez is picking up rebounds without a shoe. I think that's very impressive. They should add another one for her. She's going to be that athletic to have one shoe and still come up with a rebound.
They hold up play. Checking back in is Shook Dixon. Tatiana Perez was lacing him up. The Cypress Woods High School 6A state championship her senior year led her team to a 39-1 record. Golden. There's Dixon. Another talented freshman out of St. Louis. Dixon pull up 15-footer is in by Shug.
Has a world of talent. Her abilities are limitless when she puts forth the effort, and another opportunity for Tulsa to come up with a look on the offensive end, coming up with a big charge for Alexis Golden.
As Boudreaux, her second. I'm talking about Dixon. She was the 25th ranked player nationally by ESPN Hoop Girls, averaging 25 points a game at Lutheran North High School her senior season. So a terrific recruit for Coach Mossman. Three-pointer, yes! Golden. Another one of the talented freshmen.
Starting to feel it. The amount of talent they have on this roster, and that's why we were talking about it before, just with not looking at their record right now at 5-10 and thinking they're a blowover team. When shots fall for them, when they pay attention to the details, it is very tough to get a win on this team.
22 seconds remain in the half, 11 seconds on the shot clock. Locks us straight on, yes. She buries another one.
At some point, even when she touches the ball, I might just get in her grill. Push her way past half court at this point.
Trying to answer. And that will close out the first half as Dixon's shot hit the back of the rim. USF by 13 points after a mini run by Tulsa to climb back in it, but they have been outstanding, the Bulls have. Loxa, so potent. And the Bulls fans and band, they love it. The 22nd ranked South Florida Bulls, they are impressive. They're up by 13. Loxa, boy, it's a pleasure to watch her play. Her career record three-pointers is 8. She has 6 at the half for a smooth 24 points.
24 points is very impressive for even Loxa, and she understands what she needs to do better in this game. She had a rough spurt, couple three games where she said, I need to do better. I think this would show that she's improved in the scoring area.
Yeah, I think she's got to be happy with her play, as is Coach Jose Fernandez. His team has looked terrific. Tulsa very scrappy, made a run there at the end of the first half to close the gap a bit, but then again, Loxa hits that big tray.
24 points for her alone, and then also she is right now 6-for-9 from the three-point line. That's something that Tulsa has to do better, but that comes with a very focused defensive play.
All right, we'll check the news and notes from around the NCAA. Big upset by Washington State, Angel.
And watch that game for UCLA, number 9 team in the nation, but doesn't come down to that. It's right now making plays, and Jordan Canada is one of the most impressive guards that I've ever seen in the nation, and just a bad loss for UCLA, but also just looking at Susie Merchant and being released from the hospital after that fainting.
Situation is tough. All the best to Susie and their families there. Around the American, some news and notes. Gabby Williams, Player of the Week. She's been outstanding. And there you're talking about UConn. That's the big game coming up on Tuesday. Freshman of the week, Tamara Henshaw. We've seen some highlights from Tamara here tonight, Angel.
And then to break the streak also, UConn playing to break their streak on who else other than USF, and they take that to heart. They're excited that they get to play them at their place with the talent that they have. They are young, but they are not intimidated at all.
The Huskies going for that record, their own record, of course, trying to break that record. But who else to be there but USF? Really, maybe their toughest competitor over the last couple of years. The Bulls have an argument to say, we've played UConn tougher than anybody.
And they're fearless, and that's the one thing that I do like about them. Jose Fernandez prepares his team like no other, and they make sure that they are honed in on what they need to do to win. Not just how well UConn plays, but what they need to do in order to get the win. If Kitty Loxa is going to shoot this well and carry that into the next game, I think she's going to be the premier player to watch in that game.
The Bulls will not be intimidated. We'll take a look at some of the scores around the American.
It's been very impressive. You're seeing that Memphis over UCF right now. That's the final, as well as Houston and Cincinnati. A big win for Cincinnati, and SMU comes up a little short against East Carolina. But I've been really impressed with how well Houston has played under Coach Huey. They have the 8 wins on Huey this year. And then also for Memphis, Cheyenne Creighton, 5 straight double-doubles this year. And then also for SMU, Alicia Froling leads the league in rebounding. We can go down the line and talk about how much talent this league has. And the Temple, Bayonda Fitzgerald is the assist leader. Tulane, Kobe Morgan doing Kobe Morgan, and she is outstanding. So much talent that we can talk about in this league. But I can tell you what, this game right here is where you're going to catch most of it.
And here at the Sun Dome, it's the 22nd ranked USF Bulls over Tulsa, 36-23. And welcome back to the Sun Dome. USF up by 13 over a young but scrappy Tulsa team. But they have had absolutely no answer for Katia Loska. And not many teams do, but she is on fire.
I like the fact that you said not many teams do. It's nothing personal, Tulsa. Right now, she is just one of the most amazing shooters and scorers I have ever seen. She scored 34 points against UNC, an ACC team. Scored another 34 points against UGA, an SEC team. She is confident regardless of who she's playing, and that's why I'm so impressed of how well she does, knowing that the other team is trying to stop her. And as we see now, 24 points in the first half, it's very tough to do.
Yeah, Tulsa was proficient jumping, hedging screens, being scrappy at the beginning of the game. And actually, look at what they've done off of turnovers. So at the beginning, with that efficiency defensively, they were able to turn that into points. But since then, they've struggled on the board. They're statistically offensive end.
What I have recognized as well is that with Tulsa, they can't take as many people to the glass on the offensive side because they have to get back in transition. South Florida is very efficient in their transition offense, so they're really dropping 3-4 players back, just making sure they can stop them. So when you're looking at the rebounds, 20-12, they are not coming up with those second chance opportunities when they were shooting at 27% at one point in the first half.
Well, the Bulls, they own a plus 14 rebound margin. That is third in the nation this season. So the Bulls are doing the damage on the glass again here today. They lead it by 13 at the half. You are watching The American on ESPN. And the Bulls fans are feeling good, rock and rolling. They're 22nd ranked USF Bulls up by 13. Against a pesky Tulsa team here from the Sun Dome. We'll be back in a moment. It's the Bulls by 13 as we prepare for second half action. USF trying to make it 12 straight here at home. And you look at the leading scorers. Loxa, of course, we've talked about. Wakefield, who is relied upon heavily by the Golden Hurricane.
And with Erica Wakefield with the 6 points, it's what everyone else has been able to do, and that's stepping up, and they need to make sure that they can all contribute right now. Kendrian Elliott has 3 points, another 6 points from Alexis Godin. So a lot of those freshmen are really stepping up for this team, but Erica Wakefield knows that this is her squad, and so she has to lead in that direction, and scoring is one of them.
Well, good job, Angel, because I think you had a Tulsa fan in your pocket during that report. I don't know how you kept your focus.
I'm not sure how, but she was like, you know what? I think you should say her name, but, you know, everyone, she can take my job.
As Katia locks the Latvian, just a sophomore in Tulsa, with Coach Mossman trying to get her team fired up. They're definitely within striking distance. It's a terrific defensive team. They're 46th in the nation in three-point defense, allowing just 28% from beyond the arc. But Coach Fernandez's troops behind Loxa have been terrific.
Nothing short of it. It's been a show, a great show, might I add, that she has put on today. And it has to start with the defense and how they're going to come out to start a good rhythm.
Golden, they go back to the post with Elliott. Excellent perimeter passing. And the open lane, just couldn't knock it down, was Spurl.
I like the look at the basket. I like that she's not settling and putting the ball on the floor.
Flores gets called for the charge. As Laya a little upset with that call, well taken by Liesl Spurl.
You can see now, that was a great crossover by Flores, and she tried to avoid the contact, but still made contact on that right hip. So it is pretty interesting. That's going to be a block call in some cases, but the charge is pulled up there. Another opportunity for Tulsa.
And a pretty move in the post by Elliott, finishing with the left hand.
Need to see more of that from Elliott. I do like the fact that they aren't settling for the outside shot right now. That's two possessions in a row where they tried to find something on the inside.
Flores gets a screen from Henshaw. Jesperson. Golden is guarding Loxa with 24 points. And then Loxa gets the whistle as Golden trying to get in her path as she went to cut. Coach Mossman saying, keep those hands up. It's a big assignment for a freshman. Bujol in the corner. Loxa off of the pick. And look at the scrappiness by Golden.
I like that from her, though, because she made Kittia pass the ball out of her hands. Make someone else beat you. And right now, it's going to be Jesperson. And she's going to continue to hit these threes.
Yes for Jesperson, Maria. The junior from Denmark. She's been on the Danish national team since 2008.
And is very impressive. She's solid on the boards as well and leads his team there, but 10 plus boards on three different games. She is very solid on both ends of the floor.
And count it and a foul for Elliott. You can see the game plan here in the second half for Coach Mossman. Pounded into the talented 6'2 freshman.
Well, numbers never lie, and she understands that it wasn't a good first half for them on the outside from the field goal percentage, but getting the ball inside, they had a lot of missed opportunities, a couple missed layups, but the focus needs to be there in the second half. You have to knock down free throws as well.
Elliott with 7 points. The lead is a dozen. Pujol. Nifty ball handling, yet draws the foul. Nice move by Ariadna.
Coach says she's the biggest surprise for this team and just how impressive she has been in her improvement and being able to put the ball on the floor. You didn't see a lot of that from her last year, and she had some injuries. She had to sit out a little bit in her career, but now she is getting into a groove and understands what she needs to do to be at her best for this team, and she has done a phenomenal job just being an extra threat on the offensive side.
So checking in is Nancy Warbia, a senior from Kenya for the Bulls, and that was Ujol's first points of the night. She averages over 14 points per game.
Well, when you have another player that's scoring 24 points at the half.
Yeah, just feed Loxa.
Kind of just go with the flow, right?
And slow to get up was Warbia.
It's got tangled up a little bit.
And a steal for Flores. On the attack. Jesperson.
uncontested three. Tulsa a bit lucky on that last play.
Erica Wakefield, who has 6 points. To the rim, scoop shot is in. Beautiful take by the 5'4 junior, who had 1,800 points, 400 steals at Heritage Hall High School, McDonald's All-American nominee.
Undersized guards. You want to play at this level, you can take a lot of notes from her and how she finishes at the rim, being able to avoid the contact for the foul, but shooting under the longer arms is very impressive for Erica Wakefield.
Good help defense. Pujol in the corner with four, penetrates, leans in, and rims it in.
She's starting to feel it right now, getting to the basket with ease. And she has a nice touch around the rim.
First bucket for Ariadna, who shoots just under 50% from the field. And a walk is called by Wakefield as she ran into a big defender, Oriaba.
One too many steps, but there you want to see what your team looks like together. And those are the things that you're looking at film. Like if someone's traveling, what could you have done in the paint? Come to 2 feet, see if you can find shooters on the outside. A lot of people are going to come down and drop in on you because they know that you're a threat at the rim. See what else you can find.
Jesperson, good.
With ease, Jesperson is making it rain from the three. I love watching her shoot, and just when you think that you have stopped Kitty Aloxa from shooting three-pointers, then you have to find the next person who can do damage from the three-point line as well, and Maria Jesperson has definitely proven herself to be one of the elite players when it comes to knocking down the three.
And Jesperson is on a run of three straight double-doubles. She now has 13 points. She's going to need to grab some rebounds. She only has four on the night to keep that streak alive.
You can see her now just playing the percentages. No one's going to guard me out here, then that's fine. I'll still make the shot. Give me the ball. And why not? No one was contesting the shot, and that's when it comes down to the focus of this game for Tulsa. If you're not looking at the score, you're trying to play your best game and come out and be together and practice good habits. And right now, I'm not seeing that fight that we usually see from Tulsa.
A little demoralized, Coach Mossman trying to keep her kids in this game. They trail by 17, a scrappy young bunch. Well, you halt Loxa a little bit here in the second half, and then Jesperson starts to do the damage. This is a very talented 22nd-ranked team.
We constantly talk about how great Kitty Aloxa is as far as her scoring ability, but this team isn't ranked in the top 25 for no reason. It's not just Kitty. This team is very good, and it's very interesting to see how well this team has played together. And as you can see now, they're going to
It looked like a three from our angle. Oh, I think Loxa got hit after that made basket, so it was counted as a three-pointer. They're looking at the altercation there, the contact, which appeared to hit Loxa around the mouth. Now they're going to the replay to see if there was any intent there.
I think it was between Loxa and Gauden because she was kind of reenacting what was going on at half court and just saying she threw her bow first, so I, you know, went back, but we're going to see what all the officials caught on tape.
Both players got their arms up, but that last one, the elbow caught Katia. They're going to go with a double foul here, so Loxa and Golden will both be whistled for a foul.
We'll see here what they come up with.
Coach Fernandez and Mossman receiving the explanation. We'll take a look at this again, Angel. Let me know what you think here. If there's intent.
Yeah, Gauden was just unintentionally on Loxa, but she pushed her off of her. She made the initial contact, and Gauden didn't like it, so she threw a bow herself, but it's a double foul for both of them, and it's the right call.
Well, Golden has a little swagger for a freshman. She was the Tulsa Metro Player of the Year both her junior and senior season at Broken Arrow High School. Dixon. Watsa appears to be fine. Straight on three, bam! The freshman with a little stare down after that three. She's a big-time player.
That's the best way to answer any type of issues going on the floor. Is just, I'm going to shoot a three and knock it down. The problem is you're looking down at Bloxa.
Yeah, it's tough to keep up with the star from Latvia. 20 points a game, leading the American Athletic Conference.
That is Tulsa's 14th foul.
Fourth team foul on Tulsa. The Hurricane trail by 14. Flores waits for Loxa and draws the foul. A little bit of a reach in there on Spurl. Gatia, pretty savvy out there on how to draw fouls. You get tangled up a bit, get the whistle. I guess if you shoot 94% for the free throw line, you want to get to the charity strike.
Leading the league in free throws. Not going to hurt her to get to the free throw line, but that's one area where she's grown this year, just understanding that with her being a scorer, a lot of people are going to be upset if she knocks down a lot of, you know, points, but she has learned to deal with the contact. The last play doesn't show that, but she has learned that people are going to be after her and how to adjust and how to pick up those fouls, like you said.
16-point advantage for the Bulls. Step back, long two, hits the heel of the rim. And a battle for the rebound, out of bounds to the Bulls. Now Coach Jose Fernandez, he's looking for 298. We had a glimpse of him a moment ago. This would be the 298th victory for Jose. He's led his team to back-to-back American Athletic Conference Tournament Championships. They face UConn. To reach in, a clean strip by Dixon. Open three. Wakefield could knock it down. Terrific hustle by Erica to get it back.
A long three taken by Wakefield, but she's not a known three-point shooter, so I think that she took away from her shot even going down by pushing it and trying to see if she can get a rebound.
There's Jesperson. She's hit two trays here in the third. Brings this one to the basket. That rattles out. Battle for the rebound. Putback is in by Warriaba.
Nice way to battle in the paint. You can see now where the attention is being drawn. They're going to try and run him off the three-point line. Great look inside.
Short corner. Jay is in by Spurl. The junior from Tulsa averages 5 points a game. Open three. Rebound by Elliott off of the Pujol. Missed. Dixon.
In that situation, Chook should have passed the ball up the floor. She had Erica Wakefield as well as Gauden out on the three-point line. See what you can get. But right now, you're looking right now at Elliott being able to get to the right side of the floor, her most dominant side. Being able to knock down some free throws.
Nice quick move by Elliott. She'll be at the line to shoot two when we return. USF with Pujol in command here from the Sun Dome. Twenty-six points for Loxa, 13 for Jesperson, leading the way for the USF Bulls, up by 16 over Tulsa. You look at the upcoming schedule for Coach Fernandez and the Bulls with a big one on Tuesday.
Very big game for them, but they are not intimidated at all. Eastern Carolina having a tough season so far, but they do have Louisville coming up, and that's a big-time top 25 game for them outside of conference.
And Tulsa with Temple and then UConn, so it doesn't get any easier for this young Hurricane team.
No avoiding it. They're in your conference, so give them your best punch.
Yeah, USF, Temple, and UConn is quite a run for any team.
89 teams, to be exact.
So two free throws for Elliott. Elliott's been impressive now with 9 points, four rebounds, as she will take a break. Replaced by Scales. Or trap out of the corner. Turnover, the steal by Wakefield. She has 26 on the season. A rare turnover from Flores. Rebound captured by Flores. Flores pressured in the backcourt.
Nice job for Tulsa to get back and see what they can do. We haven't seen a lot of the defense being switched up. I haven't seen a lot of pressure for them as well to slow down the ball, but they are going to stay.
That doesn't gap. The bench having a good time with that shot. Actually bounded off the heel of the rim, hit above the backboard. This is soft touch, Angel.
Well, that's shooter's role. That's the definition of it, and she's certainly feeling it, but like I was saying before, you want to see what Tulsa's going to do in order to just throw different looks at him.
Straight on three for Richards, who now has 5 points off of the bench.
She's a rising star for this team, and being able to just step up and with confidence knock down a nice three.
And scoring off of the assist from Jesperson is Woryaba.
Catch and shoot. That's what you need to do in the paint. Be able to catch the ball and go up, make your shot.
And a steal from Nudge. Long lead pass, Jesperson. Sets herself and scores. Counted in a foul for Maria.
After
the assist from Nudge.
Certainly Flora, happy excuse me. That she chose to play basketball with both of her parents being on the national team. She said, I really wasn't sure. I tried my best, but I really wasn't good at it. But I'm glad I stuck with it. And obviously, it's worked pretty well for her, being able to step up and be just a player that she wants to be. Said she didn't feel any pressure from them, but she just has fun with it. It's, you can tell that this is something that she loves to do.
16 points for Jesperson. She and Flores will head to the bench to high fives throughout. Pujol back on the floor. Dixon, three-pointer. Good battle for the rebound out of bounds to Tulsa.
The easiest and the fastest way to get back into a game is by the three, yes indeed. Missed three here, but see the ball goes out of bounds with Elliott and Woryaba fighting for it. But at this point, don't just settle for it. If it's given to you, go for it. But I need more looks like this. When you're getting to the free throw line, find Elliott in the paint. It's very interesting. They've only gone to the free throw line three times.
Yeah,
right
just
now.
One of three.
So you put the pressure on South Florida. Make them or put them in positions to foul. Don't just settle for the outside shot. Make sure that you can get them up, get to the basket, and take advantage. See if you can exploit some of those defensive rotations.
Henshaw returns. Good minutes off of the bench for Woryaba. Seldom used, but quality minutes from Nancy for Coach Fernandez. And for Elliott, she now has 11 points, four rebounds. Loxa, who had 24 in the first half. Ujo handles it so well, the pull-up. And out of bounds to Tulsa.
Would have been nice to see that go down, I'm sure, for her. But she's shown us that she has a little sauce. She is really nice getting to the basket, behind the back, seeing she can get them up and under and a crossover. I'll tell you this, I didn't know she had it until seeing her improvement in the first couple games of the season.
Wakefield's jumper. And a tie-up on the rebound between Bond and Elliott.
Bulls basketball.
Bulls have the possession. Coach Mossman in her sixth season here.
And that's the pressure that I was talking about with you before. Just how are they going to switch it up? How are they going to make it uncomfortable for South Florida? Sporadically putting a press on them, five up. two people on one player and no one on the inbound is perfect.
Well, good time to press when Flores is on the bench. Getting a piece and blocking it out of bounds is the long defender in Jazz Bond, 6'4 freshman. Her father, Albert Bond Jr., played at Tennessee State, was a member of that team when they made two appearances in the NCAA tournament. Nice take there by Dixon. Here's Bond. Pull up is good. Smooth performer. She is going to be a good one. McDonald's All-American nominee at Blackman High School, where she scored 1,000 points. And that one rattled out from Richards.
And at this point right now, it's has Tulsa lost steam because they're getting back in transition, but they are getting opportunities at good shots. And I do believe if they really pushed the ball in transition in that series, they could have came up with 2 points because Tulsa was slow in getting back.
Well, Tulsa faces their largest deficit. Good look at Henshaw. Tough competitor Tamara is. Thirty-five seconds remain in the third quarter. Parker, here's Richards. Parker penetrates the floater, heel of the rim, and locks up out with a rebound. With 20 seconds remaining in the period, they can hold for one.
Well, she does it all anyway, so why not start the break and see if she could set it up for herself? And we rarely see her with the ball setting up the play, but we'll see what comes of this.
Takes it to the rim, scoops it up and in.
What
nice
comes
finish.
Of this? 2 points.
At the buzzer and front rim from Shug Dixon. Beautiful take by Loxa. She can do it all. Running the isolation to close the third quarter. USF.
Nice yes, pass up the lane and being able to just finish off the dribble. Count it.
Bulls by 16. And the lead is 16 for the 22nd ranked USF Bulls here in the Sun Dome as they look to improve to 2-0 in the American Conference. And they would improve to 6-0 here at home. And under Coach Jose Fernandez, this would be the 12th straight victory at home. They would be 6-0 at home here this season.
Very impressive being able to protect home court, and it's an intimidating factor as well for the other team knowing that they protect their home court so well. So it's going to be a battle. You want to come out here with the win.
Yeah, it was only UConn who could defeat the Bulls last season here at the Sun Dome. Loxo has 28 points. Pull up fading to her right, and she drains it so smooth.
Before she pulled up, make it 30. You said it. Her shot is just so smooth. It's almost like she's in practice. Everything is just in rhythm, not forcing anything up.
That three-pointer wouldn't fall for Dixon. Who Joel surveys. There's Loxa. Quick trigger. Oh, heat check there, Angel. And a foul on the offensive rebound. Pujol was undercut by Wakefield.
Let's just revisit this a little bit because I'm not sure if we really understand how impressive this 30 points is by Kitty Aloxa. And there's still 9 minutes left in this game. She dislocated her shooting pinky as well as two knuckles that were dislocated as well. The trainer had to come on the floor, put it back in place, went to the back, and she still came in the game and finished it. And that was against Arkansas State. But the type of player that she is, as Jesperson has a nice look at the basket, it's very impressive that she can play through that and still put up big numbers.
Yeah, very tough-minded, courageous kid. Look at that step through. Wouldn't fall for Wakefield. And here come the Bulls with Loxa. Hesitation, dribble, and a reach-in foul. It is whistled on Tulsa. Look at this ability by Katia. On the move to her right with the floater.
We got to figure out if there's a nickname for her, because at this point, I think that we should hashtag it Black Mamba. because she just does everything very well. And it's a Kobe. I would say it's kind of like a Kobe.
Hello, Kobe.
Yeah.
Well, it's been lots of Loxa here tonight with 30 points. Flores. Jesperson. Flores, the creator. And before that penetration, a whistle and a foul on Ebony Parker.
Flores, known for setting up so many of her teammates and being able to find her own shot as well, is something that she continues to do in the season. She can knock the ball, she can knock the shot down. And that's what's very interesting, is that her focus first is to take care of her teammates.
Yeah, very unselfish pass for first point guard is Flores, averaging 10 points a game. And the USF, when we talked to them, they said, when the Bulls need a basket, Flores can get it for them.
That's the confidence that you want to hear and you want to feel from your teammates, knowing that they will give you the ball and understand that you know what you need to do in order to put us in the right positions.
Flores, one of the stars of the Spanish national team, will step through, well defended by Tulsa. Getting her hand in there was Erica Wakefield. She's got quick hands. 26 steals on the season for the junior. Coach Fernandez. Loxa the floater, trying a wide array of shots we've seen from Katia here tonight.
None more efficient than the three as Erica Wakefield, crafty, get into the basket, finishes another nice hesitation move by her.
Oh, yeah.
Getting to what she can do best, and that's finish at the rim.
I like the way she changes speeds, they'll shift gears. And only 5'4", you've got to have a bag of tricks. Jesperson. Free throw line jumper is Aaron Henshaw. Jesperson battles before the shot. We have a foul on Tulsa.
Foul is on number three, Erica Wakefield.
Perez just couldn't control the ball as Jesperson just fights for it and gets a good look at the basket. But that shows you the type of player that she is, just being able to really come up and who wants it more. 35 rebounds already for them, and everything else seems close until you start looking at the three-pointers made.
Well,
for South Florida,
they're right on their average, Angel, with that plus 14 rebound margin that is third in the country. And getting tangled up is Pujol with a Spurl.
Fouls on number 35, Liesl Spurl. Her fourth.
That is the fourth on Liesl. Good look at Spurl. Tough competitor.
USF is in the bonus.
And there's Ariadna Pujol, all-conference freshman team back in 2014 and 15. The southpaw. A little unorthodox delivery on that shot, Angel. But she does so many things out there on the floor.
I know some left-hand players that'd be upset with that comment. They love it. It looks different because it's the left hand, but I've seen some smooth shooters knock it down with the lefty.
Spin,
I know a lot of team lefties.
Spin.
Yeah. Another lefty that you have to keep your eye out on would be from Pac-12 in Washington, Kelsey Plum, one of the best.
It was a difficult pull-up J by Dixon. Back the other way with the answer is Laya Flores.
And that's a perfect example of just taking what you're given. Flores pushing the ball up the floor, and Tulsa thought they were in place defending all the three-point shooters. Flores found the opening and finished.
Tough woman-to-woman defense. Nice take by Dixon.
She wanted the bump.
5'9 freshman, Angel.
She wanted the bump, being able to finish at the rim, and she's going to be very impressive as the year progresses and even later in her career. Seeing her grow, she's very athletic. That last move shows it.
Jesperson in the lane. Second chance opportunity, and what an effort by Jespersen. She is piling up the points here in the second half. She now has 20.
Said it over and over again, just the people that are available. We talked with Coach Fernandez at the beginning of the game. He said, who's going to come off the bench? He said, whoever's available at this point. We have to make sure that with the core that we have, that we score, and every person on this team can erupt for 20-plus points, and that's what we're seeing right now with Jespersen. It's not a surprise that she can score 20 points. She's done it before, but the fact that Kitty Aloxa has 30 and other players are starting to contribute as well is very scary looking forward for this team and defending them.
So Spurl has fouled out. She's been replaced by Elliott. Well, the bright side for Coach Mossman, Alexis Golden, 5'8 freshman, and Shug Dixon, the 5'9 freshman. What a future. Coach Mossman not happy right now and has picked up a technical. But what a future for those two in the backcourt.
She's always discussed the type of player that she wants that's going to fight for her, but it's one thing that you are excited about is the talent that you're bringing in and buying into the system and the athleticism that you're bringing in and scores and defenders as well.
Yeah, she's upset after Spurl collected her fifth foul and Loxa to shoot the two free throws after the technical. That's Coach Mossman. Associate head coach is Shane Coffey, and assistant coach is Megan Robbins, helping out Matilda. And for Jose Fernandez, his associate head coach is Jeff Osterman. He's been there 12 years. And Michelle Woods Baxter is also associate coach, 9 years now. That's great stability. And to the line to shoot two is Dixon. So Shug Dixon now with 8 points off of the bench. There's Spurl, who has been eliminated with five fouls. Urging her teammates. Dixon averages 6 points a game.
And even right now, looking at the bench and what they're being able to do is very impressive.
So Nudge was wide open for the easy deuce. First bucket for Nudge. Dixon. Now we have word that the coach told the official that that was her first technical in 6 years.
And it's very interesting to hear that too, because when you look at Matilda Mossman, she is one of the nicest coaches you ever want to play for, and just she almost reminds you of a relative or not, that she'll get on you, but it's very respectful. So her picking up a technical foul is an eyebrow.
And there's Coach Mossman. Well, Dixon will head back to the free throw line.
Another player for Tulsa, played last year, was one of the leading scorers for this team as well as in this league, was three-point specialist, and being able to step up and be the GA for this team. She's trying to figure out if she wants to coach right now, but a lot of the players really look up to her and what she's been able to do in this league, and with Ashley Clark last year as well as Ashley Grovey, Chelsea Grovey, being able to step up and leave the program. You can see now she's still giving back to this program. And I asked Coach, when you see her over there sometimes, you want to sub her in? She said, all the time.
I bet. How important is that for the young players to see that kind of stability in a program?
It's a lot, especially if a player wants to come back and give back to the program that's given so much to them.
That was a pretty backdoor cut. Bulls were just unable to knock it down. Elliott denied. Flores accelerating on the attack is cut off and fouled by Richards. Second foul on Addison. So to the line to shoot two is Laya. Flores with 5 points. Only eight assists today.
Only eight assists.
For Flores. And she averaging 6.9, which is 14th in the country.
second in the league. Very impressive.
A key component of that championship Spanish Summer League team. Good help defense by the Bulls and a tie up on the rebound. We'll stay here for the Golden Hurricane. Trailing by 22.
Sophomore Perez had a nice look at the basket. At this point, it comes down to who can finish. Elliott just missed a bunny underneath on the previous play. Now Perez missing another layup at the rim.
And they'll correct that call. They change it to Bulls ball. Light woman-to-woman pressure, full court. Flores will handle that with ease.
It's another area where Coach Fernandez said she doesn't want to just get rid of the ball. She wants the ball in her hands, and she has the confidence. Now, more with anything, the pressure.
Ucho, the short J is in off of the ninth assist from Flores.
Great court vision, being aware of where her player is and being able to knock it down with no move needed.
A sweet take by Elliott in traffic. Count the basket and a foul for Kendry as she'll head to the free throw line. USF by 22 with 4.5 minutes to play. The Bulls in command. It's been pretty offensively. Pujol the finish. You're watching the American on ESPN. National championship. I know you'll be watching, Angel. Clemson and Alabama, the one everybody wanted to see Monday night. You're watching the American on ESPN. We are at the Sun Dome, the 22nd ranked South Florida Bulls. And it's uniting the Bulls night here at the Sun Dome. You can say it in Spanish for me, Angel.
Unidos los toros.
Very nicely done. And completed the three-point play is Kendry and Elliott. Checking in for Tulsa. Number five will receive some action. Jasmine Butler, 6-foot redshirt freshman.
I'm still excited about the fact that we just showed Clemson, Alabama. They're in town, Tampa. They just left before this game tipped off. We saw about five buses leave this arena with Alabama and an escort leaving, and it's so exciting to
somehow
see college football.
Somehow I missed that, but
only the cool people saw it.
I'm not surprised they invited you.
No invite, I was just watching.
Three-pointer by Parker. And on the prior possession, Loxa collected her 34th points. Now we're gonna take a break here at the under 4 minute mark, 78-58 USF. Bulls by 20. They're having a great time here at the Sun Dome. The South Florida Bulls here in the American Conference. Everybody chasing UConn. What else jumps out at you in the standings here?
Right now, I would say Houston and how they've improved on the year, but also what Temple and Cincinnati have been able to do. Last year, they were very impressive. Had a good showing in the conference tournament and bringing back a lot of their youth, but also a lot of experience and talent. See them continue to grow in this league is gonna be fun.
Flores, beautiful pass to Nudge. And Dorotia will head to the free throw line to shoot two. Look at this pass through the lane.
I don't think it gets much better than that, just being able and being aware of where the defense is coming and who's helping off and who to get it to. That gift doesn't come overnight. So for her to have that type of style of play is very impressive. You want that in your point guard.
Her teammates must love playing with her.
Oh, I would love it.
And two free throws connected by Nudge, who averages 6 points a game. number one recruit out of Europe, rated by Blue Star Europe, Passion Hoops. Tough jump hook, pretty move there by Jessica Pagonis, the senior from Fishers, Indiana. Boxer for three, just a little short. Boxer with 34 points on the night. Dixon, oh, look at that move.
She's crafty in the paint. Gotta love it. I'm excited to watch her continue in her career.
Flores. Shug Dixon. Double-double for Jesperson. She keeps her streak alive. That is four consecutive. And there's a bucket for Perez. So didn't. The chances look bleak after one half for Jesperson to continue that streak. But what an effort here in the second stanza for Jesperson. She has 20 and 10.
What I like that Jesperson continues to do is that if her points aren't going to come as quickly as her boards do, that she's going to be consistent on the boards, and that's tough to see. But when she's going to the basket, a lot of her looks early on in this game have been getting to the rim and not just standing out on the three-point line.
Tatiana Perez, nice crossover. Seen some good guard play here tonight. Coach Mossman keeping her troops focused here late in the game, down 18. What a career she has had, Matilda. Won the Conference USA Championship and received an NCAA berth in her second season here at Tulsa. Flores leading the break. Beautiful no-look pass. Second time, no. Everything but the finish.
I always take time after a play like that to really gather my thoughts, and I'd be upset, irate, but you gotta love the confidence that she has in her players to make the shot, and I'd make sure that if she's gonna look back at me, I'm gonna make it next time.
That would have been her 10th assist. Roxa buries the three. 37 points for Katia. Well, you're speechless.
At this point, I am. I'm just going to look at you and see if you have anything else to say.
Yeah, she's amazing. I mean, we saw her warming up. I hadn't seen her play before. What a quick trigger with terrific release. The bank is open for Parker. Ebony Parker will accept that three-pointer. She may have called it.
I didn't see her call it, but guess what? It counts still. So apparently it has to be open.
There's a little sly smile for Katia Loxa. Look at this shooting release. Textbook.
And from who? Jesperson. Finding her in transition, something they do very well, as we said before. Knocks down the three, 50% for this team in transition scoring. So Jesperson is like, I may have my double-double, but maybe I can hit up on this triple-double as well.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Katia Loxa loves January 7th. Because January 7th, 2016, she scored 38, which was her career high against SMU. January 7th, 2017, she has 37 here against Tulsa.
I don't know if it's just the date or if it's just all year round where this young lady can find a way to score no matter what you do. I think at this point you should blindfold her. See how good you are. See how accurate you are if you're blindfolded.
I'd like to see you play her in horse.
I would not.
You can still play as starring at FSU not too long ago, Angel.
It feels like long ago. You know, these knees aren't what they used to be. But one thing that I love to see is when players make the game look easy, such as a lot of the players that we've seen tonight on both teams, where it's just so smooth, so talented, and just seeing them grow up along their career is very fun to watch.
Flores looking for that 10th assist Loxo will try again. That would have been a career high. Three-pointer rimming over the backboard for Loxa. The 7 threes, her career high is 8. Trays. Flores with 1:25. They just updated the stat board here. We're checking on the total for Loxa. There's a steal for Tulsa. And poked away from behind by Pujol.
Out of bounds, Tulsa ball.
We're checking if it's 37 or 39 for Loxa. Three-pointer is shy. Pujol collects the rebound with 1 minute. You look at this USF team, they are so strong, so well balanced. Angel, will their weakness down the stretch be their depth? Is that going to hurt them?
I think along the year that we've seen them play, it's always been who's injured. And a lot of their big time players have come up injured. But right now, we don't want to jinx that. And they have a great group right now, and a lot of the players off the bench are going to have to contribute, but.
Yeah, we have confirmed it's 37 points on the Loxa alert. She was going for the career high. To the rim, Pujol is fouled and hitting the deck hard. Hope everybody's okay. Being helped to her feet. Pujol assists on bringing Butler to her feet. Both teams playing hard here in the final seconds.
Shooting two, Ariana Pujol.
It's a dangerous fall there. There was a cameraman and a guy with a mop.
A lot of action over there. Just hope our camera guy's okay.
That one rattles out for Ariadna.
They
did a little piece during a timeout on Ariadna, but the messiest locker.
Also checking in for your Bulls, number 20.
The fans got a kick out of that.
And she took a bow. I mean, it was unanimous. Every single player voted her for the nastiest locker, which is very funny.
So Loxa, her night is done with 37. One shy of her career high, 20-12 for Jesperson, as her night is done as well. A good look at Katia. 13 seconds remain, and USF can look forward to the showdown Tuesday night at UConn, draining a three. It was Parker. So the Bulls, well, they didn't miss a beat here tonight. They were not looking forward to that Tuesday. They certainly put on a show for the home crowd here in the Sun Dome.
And that's what makes them great, being able to say we're going to take care of business right now. Tulsa is on our home floor. We want to make sure that we defend. And then we'll worry about the number one team in the nation in UConn, and they'll have a different game plan against them.
Well, great respect between Coach Mossman and Coach Fernandez and these two American Athletic competitors. Terrific fight by this young Golden Hurricane to stay with the talent of Jose Fernandez and the USF Bulls. And that young lady, Katia Loxa, what a show. 37 points, 7 trays, leading the Bulls to their 12th straight home victory. USF by 16 behind, 37 from Loxa, 20-12 from Jesperson, 9 assists from Flores. Here are some of the highlights from Loxa and the very talented 22nd ranked Bulls. They win it by 16 here from the Sun Dome. You're watching The American on ESPN.